Okay, I'm sure that's going to sound wonderful.
Thanks to everyone who created content for today's show. The next SJET Advisory Show will be on April 26th. And until then, I'm Sal Nuzzo, reporting for SJET. Toodles.
Welcome back to the 11th episode of the third season of SJET's The Hot Seat, the show where we usually rapid-fire questions to get to know the SJET faculty. Today, we're going to be taking a look back at the long run that The Hot Seat has had on SJET. We're going to take a look at some of the best answers from the past 30 episodes. Enjoy.
All in all, The Hot Seat takes 7 to 8 hours per episode to edit. So that's 70 to 80 hours that we've spent just this year specifically on The Hot Seat. We're excited about where we're going. We're going to try and make the quality as good as possible. We're going to keep making it better. And we really do think that the time we put into this is absolutely worth it. And we know that for years to come, new teachers are going to come through here, this very set, and you're going to keep seeing them back on The Hot Seat.
Tell me a joke.
Knock knock.
Who's there?
Pasta.
Pasta who?
An impasta. No, it's so bad.
What's the most awkward moment you've had?
I was used to canvas just for a short amount of time for the preservation of Texas rivers, going door to door. And you have a spiel, you say, to get donations. And you have to reach a quota to stay on the job. And this one day I knew I was going to get fired because I wasn't reaching the quota. And when this man opened the door, I just forgot the spiel. And instead I said, I love you.
Why are you short?
You know, genetics, biology.
Mr. Diaz, let's get right into it. Who are you?
Medgar Diaz.
What's your 5-step plan to seize control of the government?
Teach kids, indoctrinate kids, make kids love you, have them take over the government, they'll take over the world.
What's your 3-step plan to combat the coronavirus?
Lather, rinse, repeat.
And we were in this school that didn't have any Wi-Fi, and the presenter told the whole group to look up this website or, you know, go to this web link, and there was no Wi-Fi in the building. And so I, trying to serve myself, made a hotspot on my phone so I could view what she was talking about. Except my phone was named Dan Pep's iPhone, and then so immediately after, everybody in the room, it was the only network available, and everyone's going, who's Dan Pep? Who's Dan Pep? Who's Dan Pep? Who's Dan Pep? And so like 100 people tried to get on my phone, so.
What's your best pickup line?
I don't need to use pickup lines, I use loop.
What is the number one thing on your bucket list?
Would be to ride on the back of a Harley across the deserts of Arizona, wearing leather tasseled pants. Sam Elliott's up front, we're singing Born to Be Wild.
What do you do for fun?
I knit sweaters for elderly cats with diabetes.
Natural.
What is one thing not many people know about you?
I eat popcorn, like full handfuls at a time. Like, yeah. I pick up all the kernels that I can possibly fit and then just like annihilate the handful of popcorn. It's not like dainty.
What's your TikTok?
TikTok's make it rug.
What's your biggest goal?
My biggest goal, I mean, we all have the same biggest goal. We have little goals along the way, but I think my end goal would be to eventually hear those words, well done, good and faithful servant.
How do you plan to spend your retirement?
I want to learn to be one of those people at SeaWorld that swims with the whales in the shows.
What's your biggest goal?
My biggest goal is just to make my sons proud of me.
What's your littlest goal?
To survive what I'm doing right now.
What was the best meme of our last decade?
Funny you should ask. Here you go.
When you take your entire life to work out a three-variable system just to find out you misplaced a negative sign.
Mr. Roman, why do you keep emailing NHS people? Why is reading required?
To make your life more difficult.
What are your thoughts on straitjacket speed bumps?
I'm really excited to try and take my scooter off them. Should give me some good hang time.
Nice.
What languages do you know?
All of them except Korean.
¿Cómo te llamas?
Like I said, I don't speak Korean.
What was your least favorite class in high school?
Spanish. Spanish 2, Spanish 3, Spanish 1.
What's the most awkward situation you've ever been in?
I was left alone at a school dance by my date and had to be a wallflower the rest of the time.
What's the best PH you've ever given?
I caught an email cheating ring back about 15 years ago. It was awesome.
What's your biggest goal?
I would like to change the world for the better.
It's a pretty big goal.
Yep.
What's your littlest goal?
To get through this without botching it or hyperventilating. That would be really good for me.
What's the dumbest decision you've ever made?
Trying to dye my hair bleach blonde, ended up turning out ginger.
Can you burp right now?
No, but pull my finger.
No.
Is it true you do Zumba?
I do Zumba, that is true. I was duped into attending a Zumba class by some girls in college, and joke's on them, I loved it, along with one of my friends. And so we ended up doing Zumba for a couple years in college. Flash forward a few years, and I actually taught Zumba in grad school. I taught Zumba in a bar in Costa Rica and got some free drinks from the bartender. Awesome. As good business for them. Somewhat indirectly, I actually taught Mila Kunis how to do Zumba for the movie Bad Moms.
Oh my gosh.
What is the number one thing on your bucket list?
I don't keep a real bucket list. I don't. I haven't really thought about it. I live pretty close to reality. I take one day at a time, and I just try to do the right thing every day. And I've done some fun things, but I haven't not done anything I've really wanted to do. Just trying to do the right thing today.
Which student annoys you most when they come into the ARC?
Any of them that come in with their shirt untucked.
What's the weirdest thing you've ever eaten?
Dog food.
So disgusting.
Why are you not tall?
Because I'm short.
Who are you?
I'm just a small town girl living in a lonely world.
Nunez, who are you?
Yes.
What's your littlest goal?
To get through this segment.
From a student, where does one get such big calves?
Good genes.
What's your littlest goal?
To make someone laugh right now.
What's your hidden talent?
I can put my arms behind my back in prayer.
What's your hidden talent?
So if you're squeamish, you might want to look away for a second.
When was the last time you went to a barber?
Probably 6 years ago.
What's one thing that not many people know about you?
I'm actually really sweet.
What advice would you give to a freshman asking a girl to homecoming?
Don't do it.
How do you plan to spend your retirement?
I don't. I plan on dying in the classroom like a Supreme Court judge dying on the bench.
What was the best part about quarantine?
Wearing the same clothes for 4 days in a row.
What was the worst part about quarantine?
Smell.
Did you suck?
No, I didn't suck. No, I played tennis. I played soccer. I ran track, I pole vaulted, and I was the captain of the bowling team.
What do you even do here?
I eat breakfast, go to class, grade some essays, give Fs, and then go home.
What would you change your name to if you had the ability to?
Probably Kyle Ray Jepsen, and release my own version of Call Me Maybe.
What was your favorite class in high school?
English.
Why?
I got to write about absolutely nothing and make good grades.
From Sean Connolly, do you polish your head?
Unfortunately, I don't. I think I just have an oily head that makes it shiny.
What was your favorite class in high school?
Math.
Why?
Because it's all that really matters.
What's the derivative of cosecant?
Pass.
What's the derivative of e to the negative x?
That would be negative e to the negative x.
That's right. What's the funniest PH you've ever given?
Any PH I give is hilarious to me.
What's the best PH you've ever given?
My first year teaching, I had a student come into class and threw a live lizard onto another student.
Wow.
Yes, and the student who received the lizard screamed, as you can imagine. Half of the students in the class got on the ground and started crawling around trying to catch the lizard, and the other half started screaming and standing on their desks, and it left me just staring at the kid who threw the lizard like, are you happy? Is this what you wanted? Is this what you wanted? It was terrible.
Who's the most intimidating teacher at Strake?
Mr. Lovin.
What's your favorite thing about your job?
Mr. Lovin.
Same.
If you could be any animal, who would it be?
I would definitely be a possum because I think they're misunderstood, and I connect with possums. They're very cute and faithful, and they don't always hang out upside down, but they can if they have to, and they're not concerned about their appearance when they get older. So,
do you want a pet possum?
I would love to have a pet possum. I think I don't know if I could have it long term. Jesuits don't typically have pets, but after a puppy, I think a possum would be a second best.
Okay. Second, really, after a puppy.
If you could be any inanimate object, what would it be? The sword from the movie Braveheart. If you could be in your favorite movie, who would you be? The sword from the movie Braveheart.
Who's your favorite freshman?
I plead the fifth.
For Mark Tayar, who is your least favorite student and why is it Preston Popov?
Because he is the most obnoxious LSU fan.
If you were Kevin McAllister from Home Alone and you were Home Alone, what traps would you set up in your house?
I will smash glasses on the window so that the barefooted vandalers of the bandits will break their feet or cut their feet so they couldn't walk anymore. And then I can beat them up with a bat. A 2x4, better.
What about a ruler?
No, 2x4.
So how many rulers have you gone through in your straight Jesuit tenure?
I think that kind of information should not be dissolved in this environment.
What was the most awkward thing that you did in high school?
Graduating, going to college, and coming back to high school forever.
What's the most awkward moment you've had?
I once ripped my pants while teaching.
Do you care to elaborate?
I was teaching, and there was not a hole in my pants. And then, I was still teaching, and there was a hole in my pants.
What's the most awkward situation you've ever been in?
I actually took a girl out on a first date, and getting out of the car to go to dinner, I ripped my pants.
It's pretty bad.
It was rough. Didn't get a second one.
From a student, what's the lowest test grade you've ever given?
If you've gotten it, you know.
That's a good answer. From Sean Varkey, can I touch your head?
After.
Okay, after. I'm looking forward to it.
We're all done. There you go.
What's your favorite item on the SJET dining menu?
I like the pozole.
Michael Pozole. What's the most awkward moment you've had?
Well, I have a lot of awkward moments, but this one is at the top.
And we will see you guys next time. Thank you for watching.
Thank you, Straight Jesuit. Have a great day.
Well, guys, thanks for watching The Hot Seat. Thanks to everyone who submitted questions, and make sure to submit your questions for Mr. Voldy. See you next time.
Thanks for watching, guys. We're looking forward to interviewing some new teachers in the future, but not Mr. Voldy. See you next time.
Thanks, guys. Next up, in line with the theme of looking back on SJET's past years, we've compiled the best responses from the SJET original series, The Hot Seat, as we look back on the last 3 years. Let's check it out.
welcome back.
Gentlemen, Barney is killing our ratings. He must be dealt with. He must be killed.
I love you. You love me. Trees went back. Me and Del were singing. Little runaway. I was flying. Yeah, right.
I'm Scott Vanz, and this is the third of our three-part series on wrestling. And the rumor is tensions are high, and things are getting really hot and heavy. Mr. Kanye, what do you have to say? I hear that Mr. Sanak, this might be the day. Mr. Sanak, I hear, is really out to get you. I think today might be it. What do you think?
Well, I tell you what, I've really had enough of Mr. Santarcangelo. As far as I'm concerned, I don't want him in my sight. I don't want him anywhere around me. He can stay away from me. Wait a minute.
Hey.
Look, I told you, buddy, I don't want you
you're
around
talking
here.
About me?
Yeah, I'm talking
about
you.
Me.
Yeah, you. I don't want you. Hey!
Table twist! Table twist, gentlemen!
Well, and there you have it. That's the Kanye Santarcangelo fight. Looks like it was pretty much a draw. Not exactly what we had in mind for the Korean lecture room here, but nonetheless, a pretty good fight. For Jim and I, this has been an SJET Wrestling Federation match.
You can't beat him. He has no weaknesses. He's
John Cena!
It's the Jerry Martinez Show, starring Straight Jesuits, one and only Coach Jerry Martinez. I'm Joe Biondi, inviting you to be with us tonight when Jerry's special guest star will be Coach Mike McConnell of the St. Thomas Eagles. And now, here's Jerry! Good afternoon, Coach.
Good afternoon.
How are you doing? I think you're going to be a little bit distressed at who our next guest is tonight. It's Coach Mike McConnell from the St. Thomas Eagles. Let's bring him on. Hey, Coach. Look at him walking. Good afternoon, Coach. Good afternoon. Okay, Coach Martinez, after Jesuit's victory over St. Thomas 33-8, did you think the Crusaders performed as well as they should have?
Well, you know, Joe, I was really happy with our performance, not only on the offense, but on the defense. We played a fine football game. And I'm telling you, we really, really gave it all our heart. We did. And I was happy because not only did we beat the Eagles, but we also beat St. Thomas 33-8. All right? That's enough to be said.
Okay. Coach McConnell, although the Eagles lost the game last month, how do you think they fared against the Crusaders?
Well, offensively, Big Red had the edge. You're crazy. What are you talking about? You're crazy.
We have another edition of the show.
To weigh the consequences of your actions, Squirrel Man.
You're nuts!
Now for a special message from Justin Huang.
Hey! What are you doing here?
I'm here to do my skit.
Dude, you quit. Like, you can't just, like, come back.
Well, someone invited me. Was it you?
No, I didn't invite you.
Well, who was it?
I don't know.
I called him back. Justin's willing to stand up in front of the camera, do SJET weather, and embarrass himself in front of the whole school. He's the obvious choice.
No.
Attention, all Straight Jesuit students. Justin Hong is in great danger and needs your help to report the weather. To do this, he needs a green screen and a couple of outdated memes. To help him, all he needs is your credit card, the three numbers on the back, and the expiration month and year. But you gotta be quick so that Justin can make his memes and achieve epic weather royal.
Thanks, guys. Next up, to celebrate 50 successful years of operation, Andrew Nice and Joey Montroy compiled this highlights video of the archives from the last 50 years of SJET.
Good morning, SJ, and welcome to another edition of CSN Sports Desk. I'm Thomas Hatfield. That's Alejandro Mejia. We got a lot to talk about. Alejandro, get us started with
rugby.
All right,
so to start off, Varsity White and JV Green traveled down to Pearland on Friday to take on the Brazoria Spartans rugby team. JV Green fell behind early but fought back to make it a close game, falling 24-19. Varsity White faced the undefeated Brazoria Senior Club and fell short 55-12. JV White participated in the St. Thomas High School 10S tourney, going to a 2-1 on the day. Varsity Green hosted West Houston Rugby Club on Saturday and lost 68-12. The overall record for Varsity Green is 3-2, 1-2 in district, and 2-0 in the Single School Cup. Varsity Green will travel to St. Pius X on Thursday to take on the Panthers at 7 p.m. Varsity White and JV Green will host the Woodlands Rugby Club on Saturday at 10 a.m. and 11:30 respectively.
Now moving over to soccer, the varsity soccer team opened the playoffs with a 2-1 win over Dickinson last Friday. The game was close the whole way, with Jesuit pulling ahead by a goal with Ben Callagher with 6 minutes to go. The team continues their playoff trek tonight against Dobie.
All right, and for water polo, last Wednesday, the water polo team played Memorial in the district matchup. Our JV lost 10-6, but Varsity won 12-10 in front of a hot crowd. Both teams were also in action at home last Saturday. Varsity went 3-0, with the first match being a 12-3 over Dallas Jesuit. The second match was against Brazoswood, and it was a close game throughout. The Crusaders scored a last-minute goal in stoppage time to win 12-11. The last match of the day was versus Stratford, also a win. JV went 1-1 with a win versus Dallas Jesuit and a loss versus Brazoswood. Varsity is 18-1 on the year, and JV is 6-5.
Now going over to baseball, they bounced back from a tough start to district play with 2 losses to Pearland. However, the Crusaders got wins of 10-0 and 12-1 over Hastings to bring their record to 2-2 on district play. Their next series begins today against Shadow Creek, which is away. They will play the back end of that series this Friday at home. The first pitch for both games is 6 p.m. And now moving over to a brand new segment here for Sports Desk Analysis. And today we are going to break down the new football schedule for next season. Alejandro, your initial thoughts.
So honestly, we've got a nice setup here. Our first game will be against Fulshear and then Decaney. It's gonna be a tough game, what do you think?
Yeah, Fulshear coming up from 5A. This is their first year of 6A play. Will be their first ever 6A football game. Barely made the playoffs last year, had a losing district record, just snuck into the playoffs, had a bit of a Cinderella run, but they got knocked out after a few games. But Decaney, you may remember, we played them last year. We did beat them rather convincingly, 55-21. Spring, same district as, actually, I believe they're the same district as Westfield. I don't know if that's correct, but they made the playoffs last year, lost out to Duncanville. And then we get into district play. Start off homecoming against Elsick. Alvin should be a good one as well. Dawson That's the first big game on the 8th, on the 7th of October. That should be a pretty big game right there. Again, last year was a very competitive game.
Very competitive.
Only lost by 3.
Yes. And then we have Aleef Taylor, another district game following Hastings, Pearland, and Shadow Creek. Those last two games will be very big. Thomas, what do you think?
Oh yeah, biggest two games of the year. Pearland is at home. Be sure to come out to that one. And also be sure to catch all the games next year on Crusader Sports Network. If you go to the Max Prep schedule, ignore the parts where it says the games are on weekends like Saturdays. That's just a typo, they'll fix that. So.
Well, that's all we have for you here today on CSN Sports Desk. I'm Thomas Hatfield.
And I'm Alejandro Mejia, and we will see you next time.
Good morning, Strike Jesuit. I'm Sal Nuzzo, and today is Tuesday, March 29th, day 7 on your schedule. And this is today's SJET Advisory Show. To start it off, I'm going to hand it over to Alejandro Mejia and Thomas Hatfield in the studio for our next sports update.